A St. Louis Baby 2 survey helped to make a nuclear test ban a reality. The study looked at how much radioactive fallout from above-ground tests was entering people's bodies, specifically children. Dr. Luke Ritter is the assistant professor of history at New Mexico Highlands University. He's with us this morning with more on what has changed over the years. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Now, first off, this is a huge survey. So kind of explain the tooth survey and what went on here in St. Louis.
It's a remarkable story.
Yeah, it is.
A group of scientists and citizens collected over 320,000 baby teeth to study how much nuclear fallout was entering humans' bodies. From between 1945 and 1963, there were hundreds of above-ground nuclear weapons tests conducted in Nevada, especially, but also in the Bikini Atoll in the Pacific. And St. Louis women, mothers, were concerned about how much of the nuclear fallout was getting into Americans' diets. Early fallout studies showed that a not insignificant level of strontium-90, a byproduct of a nuclear blast, was getting into the local cow's milk supply. And so they were wondering how much of that cow's milk is being imbibed by infants and young children, and how much of the strontium-90 is getting into Americans' diets. So the baby teeth were a way for them to study the amount of strontium-90 that Americans were getting.
It's very interesting. What did they find?
Well, it took them a while to collect the teeth and do the studies, but they found a correlation between rises in strontium-90 in human bodies and nuclear weapons tests. They were able to demonstrate convincingly that 1 in 3,000 children were likely to contract thyroid cancer in certain counties in Utah. They presented this before a special congressional meeting. And I argue that this played a significant role in convincing John Kennedy's administration to cancel above-ground nuclear weapons tests in 1963.
Yeah, they had then that treaty ban then, right?
That's right. That was the treaty ban.
Why do you think people are still so interested in this? Because you have something coming up later tonight, and a lot of people, I think, will be attending this. It's interesting.
Right. There's a new documentary coming out called Silent Fallout, and the Missouri History Museum is showing a special preview tonight. The people will be admitted to the Missouri History Museum at 5 p.m. The documentary will start around 6. There will be a special panel with people who are in the documentary to field questions. Yes, people are still very concerned. Even though nuclear weapons tests have stopped, there are still concerns about nuclear waste, nuclear power plants, and currently there are studies being conducted to see how much nuclear fallout Americans are still contracting.
All right. Dr. Luke Ritter, thank you so much for your time this morning. We appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Once again, you can see him tonight. There is the information on your screen. We're going to take a break. We'll be back.